example of the different pre-start techniques before they're brought down in the command.
Keep the intensity up. She's doing that. Let's take a look at this 50 split. 29.85. The other two competitors around her are in the 30 seconds.
Titmus continues to dictate the pace and the pressure. One lap to go. She's almost a second ahead now and almost a second behind world record pace. What a race, leading from start to finish. 5 meters to go. Just a couple more strokes. Ariarne, champion.
What a swim. There's Tasmania, which is one of the smaller places in. So Tasmanians would be absolutely celebrating as well. Defending the 400 meters freestyle here in Paris. They are looking for a fourth consecutive gold medal in this event. Both were 2016 champions. The USA Simone is in.
Take your marks.
China in three, Australia in four, the US in five. That's the middle of the pool.
That is a world record based on the relay, not the individual. Let's check it at the 50-meter mark and see where everyone is.
How about the first 50 from Anna Hopkin up in lane number one?
She's a great 50 freestyler, straight arm. Oh, great underwater by Simone Manuel.
But it is Wo from China, who now has gone to the opposite side of her lane in order to get some clean water. But Australia, only moments away from yet another win in the 4x100 free relay. Meg Harris now with a full body length lead. It's soon to be official. The green and gold of Australia has struck gold here in Paris once again.
And there's the winning touch. Makes her the most prolific Australian Olympian in history. And here he is, Elijah Winnington, representing Australia. Of course, Ian Thorpe held the world record before Paul Biedermann.
As the 400 free for both men and women has evolved over the years, Lucas Martens still in front, still under the world record, but that turn hurt him. That turn really disrupted his rhythm. Now it's about racing. How can he get his hand on the wall first?
Well, this is where the fatigue starts to set in, and Kim is really making a move on him. This is going to be a really big battle.
How about Winnington at the bottom? That's Elijah Winnington finding some speed, as is Aaron Shackle in lane number seven. But it's Martens. A century ago, it was Johnny Weissmuller who ruled the pool. Today, it is Lucas Martens, who is king of the aquatic jungle.
Here in Paris, it's from the Gold Coast in Australia, a beautiful part of the world.
In lane number five, it will be the men's team from Australia, starting off with Jack Cartwright.
But let's see what we need to keep an eye on this 100 freestyle world record.
If the sprint freestylers are considered the gladiators of the sport, then the 4x100 men's free relay is like a training session in Sparta.
A lot of wash out there as well, so the smart swimmers will be trying to avoid that. Let's take a look at the first 50 meters. That 0.75 under world record split is from the relay. Maybe leading now, but there may be a change here. Let's see. They have been beaten before on three occasions in Olympic history.
That's Kyle Chalmers doing his best to salvage a silver, but no one is going to catch the United States of America. Caleb Dressel gives this country yet another gold in the men's 4x100 freestyle relay.
So close for second and third, only 35-100 separating the silver and bronze medals. That is Kai Taylor, whose mother Hayley Lewis won a silver and a bronze medal in the 1992 Olympic Games in Barcelona in freestyle. Race Janet Evans in the 4 and the 8.